So yeah, today we are going to see a demo about how to consume a Power Platform custom connector in Microsoft Copilot Studio. And this demo is a part of a set of labs and demos that we have in the Copilot Developer Camp, which is a set of training materials that we provide to help you learn how to extend Microsoft 365 Copilot, whether you are a low-code or a pro-code developer. Here you can find the URL for the Copilot Dev Camp. And in the labs, we have content which goes from the maker path to the code path, depending on what you want to do and build. And today, we are focusing our attention on the Microsoft Copilot Studio section, so the MCS series of labs. And if you will complete all of the labs in any of the pathways, you will also have a chance to get a badge. So why not doing that? So you will get a badge for each and every pathway, and you will get a specific badge if you will get all of the badges for all of the pathways, and the red one, the Sensei, Sample Sensei one, if you will also share with the community a sample that you built on top of Microsoft 365 Copilot. But that said, let me move to the demo. I will sit down if you don't mind, because I need to work on my keyboard, but nothing personal, okay? So let me switch to the demo desktop. And what we are going to see today is a demo of an agent which can consume an external Power Platform custom connector. First of all, let's have a look at the agent in action so that you can understand what we are talking about. And then I will explain you how it works under the cover. This is an agent which hypothetically helps people in the HR department to manage candidates. And as such, we have functionalities like, for example, the option to get the list of candidates from an external service that we use to support this agent. As you can see here, I have a prompt, get all candidates from an external HR service. I'm a developer, so the prompt sounds quite a developer-oriented prompt. I apologize for that, but this is the prompt that will trigger my external connector. And as you will see soon, with a secure connection to my external API, I will be able to retrieve the list of candidates that I have in my external system. Now, what is interesting to notice is that behind the scene of this prompt, the agent was able to consume an external API that I'm going to show you right now. This is my API. As you can see right here in the terminal window, I've just got a request. And we can also see that the request was sent by my user. So we have authentication in place and we can have authorization in place, which is really cool from a security point of view. Now, from an implementation point of view, here is how I implemented my set of REST APIs, my function. This is an Azure function that I implemented using TypeScript. And in this one, we simply have the definition of the candidate object, which is the one that I return as the result of my request. And I have a get candidates operation, which will simply rely on a really simple JSON file with a fake list of candidates just for the sake of keeping the demo simple and easy to recreate on your own environment. And here you can clearly recognize that we have the same candidate that we have got back in the agent. Now, the overall idea of this sample API is to get access to this information in a secure way, as I was telling you. So here we can see that inside the API, whenever we get a request, we also do a validation of a token, of an open authorization token that we get in, and we want to have in every single request we process. And when we validate the token, we also look for a specific permission scope in the token, which is called or with name hr.consume. Then I will not dig into all of the technical details about the token validation, but just to give you an idea, I rely on an API that we have on GitHub that one of my colleagues, Valdek Mastikarth, implemented, which is the JWT validate or job validate. Using this JavaScript library, we can easily validate a token based on an Entra ID setup. So this API is also made available through an open API definition, which is this JSON file, through which I declare that I have my API/candidates endpoint. And through this one, I can get all of the candidates. I define what a successful response will be. I define eventually what are the other APIs that I offer, like the capability to add a new candidate or to manage the list of candidates and stuff like that. Now, I have this API, and this is running locally on my machine, and I'm relying on a dev tunnel to make it available to the Power Platform. I also have in Entra ID, let me move the Teams window. In the Entra ID, I have a registration of an application. So we can go here under application registrations, and we can see that I registered an application called HR Service API, which is something that you need to do if you want to rely on Entra ID for security. This is the application which describes my API, so which declares the API that I'm offering to my consumers. You can see here there is the overview page with all of the general information like the application ID and the directory tenant, but now I'm interested in the expose an API section. In fact, in this one, I'm offering an API with a permission scope called hr.consume, which is exactly and precisely the one I was showing you before in the source code of my Azure function. This hr.consume permission scope is offered to consumers using also this unique API URI that you can see right here, which is actually based on the unique client ID of my API application. Now, I have my application registered in Entra ID, so I'm exposing this API with this permission scope. In order to consume this API, I also need a consumer application. So still in Entra ID, I registered an HR service consumer app, and this one will be configured to have a client secret, for example, for the sake of handling the security and the retrieval of a token for this consumer application. And from an API permissions point of view, in this application, I granted the permission to access my HR service API with the hr.consume permission scope. So basically, this is the consumer application of my service API. And this consumer application will be used by the Power Platform to securely access and consume my API. How? Well, in the authentication section for this application, I have configured the web authentication platform. And here you can see there is a redirect URI, which looks like something generated by Microsoft, not by me. And that's the case. And I'm going to show you where you can get this kind of URL through the Power Platform. So now I have the actual implementation of my API as a TypeScript Azure function. I have the API application registered in Entra ID, and I have the consumer application registered in Entra ID. It is now time to configure my connector. So let me move to the Power Platform, and let me show you how you can create such a connector. I'm already in the custom connector sections. You can find it under more if you cannot find it in the short list right here. And here, when you want to create a custom connector, you can simply import an API, for example, using an open API file, which is precisely what I have in my solution and what I showed you before. So let me do the initial steps of creating this connector. So HR service to, for example, will be the name of my second connector. And I'm going to import the JSON file that I showed you before with the open API definition. By doing that, the Power Platform connector creation UI will read the open API definition and will generate the basic settings for my connector. I will still need to provide a description for my connector, like HR service connector to consume a list of candidates, just for the sake of it. I will still have to provide a URL, which can be something at service.com. I don't care, because then I will show you the real one. And when we move to the security section, from here, you can configure the actual security settings of your connector. So, for example, I can choose any of these options, and I'm really interested in the open authorization one, because it's the one that I prefer, honestly. And with open authorization 2.0, we can then choose what is the identity provider that we want to use when consuming securely with open authorization our API. And in our scenario, clearly, it will be Azure Active Directory, which is the old name of Entra ID. By choosing Azure Active Directory, you can then configure all of the settings of what? Of the consumer application that you registered in Entra ID. So, for example, in our scenario, we had the HR service consumer application. So, we should provide the client ID of that application right here. We should provide the client secret, which is of course hidden right now, so I'm not going to copy and paste it right now, but then I will switch to the actual and real connector. You need to provide the authorization URL, which usually and by default is the right one already, but in case you are on GCC tenants or stuff like that, you might need to change the URL. You can specify the tenant ID, or you can use common to use a multi-tenant application. And here it is another important part of the story. You need to provide the resource URL of the resource that you want to consume with this connector application. What do I mean? Well, when I registered my consumer application in Entra ID and I said API permissions, and I granted the hr.consume permission to this application, actually, this hr.consume permission refers to an API which is identified in Entra ID through its unique API URI. And this is precisely what you need to specify in the setting of your connector. So if you look at the HR service API, when we expose an API, this application ID URI is the value we are looking for. So we can paste it here, and we can specify the scope we are interested into, one or more. So hr.consume is the permission scope we want to use. So once you have configured all of the security settings, let me move to definition. Here you can see that thanks to the OpenAPI specification file that I provided while creating my connector, I already have all of the endpoints configured and available for my connector. So I see I have the get candidate endpoint that we used before. I have the add, the get, and the remove candidate. And for each of them, we have the definition of the request from a REST point of view. We can see what the content of the request and the response gives. And we can do fine tuning of our API. So now let me cancel this one and let me switch to the real one to show you how it is configured. And as I was telling you, okay, of course, here I have a nice looking or supposed to be nice looking icon. Again, I'm a developer, so I'm not really a good designer. I have the description, I have the real URL. This is the URL of my dev tunnel endpoint. And in the security settings, as I was showing you before, I have the real client ID, the real client secret, and all of the settings of my API. And here, as you can see, we have the redirect URL. So once you create your connector, and once you configure and save all of the security settings, you will then be able to copy the URL that you will need in the authentication settings of your consumer. And this is the URL that you can see right here. Copy it, paste it in the authentication settings of your consumer application, and you are done. Then again, we have the definition of all of the operations. And from the UI of the Power Platform connector, we can also test our connection. We can reuse a connection which I already created in my environment, and we can register a new connection, which basically means use a different set of credentials if you want, and create a fresh new access token and refresh token. I can rely on the one that I have already, and I can test my APIs. So for example, I can test the get candidate operation. As you can see right here, this is the answer I've got back, and this is the JSON I've got back from my API, again, with the well-known list of candidates. One more time, if I go back to Visual Studio Code, we can see that I've got my request right here, again, under the identity of my user right now. So we are almost there. Now we have the API, we have the application registered for the API, we have the consumer application registered, and we have the connector configured in the Power Platform. We simply need to use the connector inside our Copilot Studio agent. And that is my agent, the one I was showing you before. And if we look into the actions section, we can see that here I already have the action that I showed you before in action, but sorry for the trick of words, but I can create a new action right now. And by searching right here for hr-service, which is the name I gave to my connector, I can see that I have all of the operations available for my custom connector. And the get all candidates is the one I was using before. So we can choose it, and we can create a new action targeting this operation. Of course, that's what I already did right here. So if I open and edit this one, the get all candidates will use user authentication from a security point of view, meaning that every single user who will consume this agent will have to authenticate against my backend API, and the consumption of the API will happen under the identity of the user with a delegated access token. So every single user will be able to see through the API what they are allowed to see based on their identity and based on their authorization profile, which is really important. Okay? Then we have, in case of any, the definition of all of the inputs and output arguments so that we can shape the input and the output that we will get from the action. We can also rely on the same actions also in topics. So if you want, you can create a topic and you can consume the same connector from a topic as well if you want to create a conversational flow, single turn or multi turn in Copilot Studio. But what is really important that you can easily, once you have configured the connector, you can easily get access to the connector APIs through the Microsoft Copilot Studio interface. So I think that's all for me. I simply switch back to the slide deck for 1 second to say thank you and back to you, Vesa.